Up to yesterday, what we discussed is how to represent numbers. Some of you is unmuted. Kindly mute yourself if you have nothing to ask at this moment. How to represent numbers, then first of all, how to represent the positive integer numbers, then we have seen the negative integers numbers, the two's complement, and eventually one thing that within the computer, it is only the bit pattern that is important. Computer understands only the bit pattern, nothing more than that. So this representation, two's complement and so on, all the representations that you're going to see later on, they are solely for human representation, right? Eventually, if we have this, there should be some proper protocol that if you're given a number, how throughout all the digital electronics media, there should be one common rule, one common protocol that how that is going to be represented in terms of ones and zeros, right? So this representation, two's complement, and later on today, as we'll see about the representation of floating point numbers, that means the real numbers, they are just common representations used throughout as a protocol used throughout the used globally. So eventually, the same bit pattern, because eventually underlying the computer system, the CPU understands nothing, does not even bother about by 1101001, you are representing -39 or 217. You have given it the bit pattern. You have told it to add something. It will do the job. Okay. So today, we are going to start our discussion about real number representation. How real numbers are represented within the computer system. Firstly, we will take a simple real number and how to convert that into binary, and what is the general techniques that is used in today's digital electronics medium. So suppose I have a number, say 4.25. Okay, the fact is, for such numbers, you separate this real integer part and the real part. This is the first task, separate the integer part and the real part. Now, these two parts, the two separate parts, needs to be converted separately. That means what? These 4, so again I am writing this here, 4.25, this 4 will be converted to 100, right? That's in decimal dot. Now this 0.25, this needs to be converted. To convert this decimal point, in general, you will multiply, in case of integer part, you divide by 2 continuously. For the real part, you multiply by 2 continuously. So 0.25 into 2, it is eventually, just one second, in fact, I do not have electricity at this moment. Just wait for a few minutes. Okay, so back online, interruption occurred due to I have to connect it at some other point. Okay, so recording is already started, so let me share the screen. So what I was saying is that this 0.25 into 2, that means for the integer part, let me recapitulate again. You will separate this integer part and real part.
Sir.
Ha, bolo.
Sorry, sir, but could you please start again?
Okay, sure.
Thank you.
See, today we are going to discuss about this real number representation. Okay. In the real number, how will you represent some real number? Some one number that contains these decimal points. In such numbers, you will first separate these two parts, this integer part and the real part. Okay. After separating these two parts, in fact decimal part. Now these two parts need to be converted separately. Now for the integer part, you have seen that we divide by 2 continuously. Right? We have divided by 2 continuously and then we have taken the remainder. For the real part, we will multiply with 2 continuously. So this was 0.25. Consider this is only the real part, only the decimal part, right? The complete number is a real number. So this is only the decimal part. So 0.25 into 2, this will give you 0.5. Now write this integer part here, then 0.5 into 2, that will give you 1.0. integer part is 1, so 1 here. Then we have achieved 0 here. We have achieved 0 here. So there is, so we end the conversion here. So 4.25 in binary will be 100.01. That will be in binary. But this 100 represents 4 and 01 represents 0.25. Now, how will you convert it back into decimal? For integer part, we know that we multiply it with the increasing power of 2. And the powers of 2 that we use is 0, 1, 2. And obviously the result, that's why comes out to be 2 square. Right? Now, continuing this direction, 2, 1, 0, minus 1, minus 2. And just like we have done in the integer part, we are going to do the same thing for the decimal part as well. Obviously, this will give you 0 into 2 to the power minus 1. So there is no point in writing that. Just write the 2 to the power minus 2. And you'll get, see, 2 square gives you 4. And 2 to the power minus 2, that means 1 by 4 gives you 0.25. And eventually, this will give you 4.25. Back.
Excuse me, sir.
Ha, bolo.
Sir, can you please once again tell about this 0.25 part? How to write that in?
See, this is 0.2. Now, 0.25 for any real part, you will multiply with 2 continuously. So, 0.25 into 2, that will give you 0.5. And write this integer part. So, this integer part. This integer part is here. Okay. Then this integer part. Now keep this 0.5 only. 0.5 into 2. Multiply with 2 again. This integer part is here. Okay. Then as we received 0 here, we'll stop. There is no point in multiplying 0 with 2. There is no point in multiplying that. So we'll simply stop here. In fact, it will be clear. I'll show more and more examples. Suppose I'm going to convert something. Let me take something more challenging. So 13.8. Though this is not that much challenging as well, but still, 0.8, you'll see that 0.8 will lead you to infinite number of bits. Let me show you. Firstly, I need to convert 13. Again, just like the previous discussion, separate the integer part and separate the decimal part. For the integer part, 13, what is its corresponding binary? 1, that gives you 8, 1101 will be the result in the case of binary. Okay. In fact, you can check it out, because this gives you 1, this gives you 4, this gives you 8. So 13 point. Now this 0.8 part. So 0.8 into 2. For 13, you divide it by 2 continuously. In fact, if you divide by 2, as you know, I think this is already known to you by now. So 1101. Okay. What happened? Just 1 second. Okay, it got restarted somehow. Some problem is happening. Okay. So, I am running it via, in fact, virtual machine, these windows. So, 1101. Okay. And now, this 8 here. So, 0.8 into 2. So, is this part clear? That separating this integer part and the decimal part, and then converting the integer part as you have done till now. That means simply by dividing by 2 and so on. Okay. And for the real part, for the decimal part, as I've discussed, multiply with 2 continuously. So 0.8 into 2, that gives you 1.6. Okay. So write this integer part directly here. 1. Then now we'll multiply 0.6. Not 1.6. Remember, I have taken this 1, already here. Okay, what I left with is now the 0.6 part, and what we have is 1.2. We have 1 again, so write 1 here again. Then we have 0.2. So 0.2 into 2, that gives you 0.4. So what should I write here? Anyone?
Zero.
Yes, 0, because it is 0 here. Then 0.4 into 2, 0.8, it is again 0 here, 0 again. Now see, we do not need to write further, because we have received this 0.8 back. So if you multiply it again continuously, you'll get that 1.6. You'll get that 1.6, then 1 here, points. That means we are in the loop. 0.6 will be multiplied with 2 again, and so on. So this part will be repeated again and again. And so you are going to get 1100 continuously. So 1100, 1100, and so on. Infinite number of bits you'll require. So what you can write it here is something like 1101 1101.1100 as as the recurring decimal of 1100.
But sir, 1100, it's 0.75, I think.
Yes, it will not give you the 0.8 exactly, because to get 0.8 exactly, I have written the recurring decimal. That means it is not finite. 1100, 1100, 1100, and so on. It will continuously go. To represent 0.8 exactly, you will need infinite number of bits to store. You will have to store all these bits. Okay. Otherwise, the larger number of bits that you will store, the closer you will get to 0.8, but you will never reach 0.8. As for example, if I write say 0.1100, as I have said, yes, this will give you, this is 2 to the power minus 1, because this is minus 1 and this is minus 2, 2 to the power minus 2, right? This gives you 0.5, this gives you 0.25, eventually this gives you 0.75, this is not 8. But if you take 110011, maybe you will get a bit closer. Maybe 0.75 plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 2 to the power minus 5. Remember this minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, and so on. Plus 2 to the power minus 6. Calculate this, what comes as the result? You'll get something, I think 0.78 or 79, something like that.
0.796.
Okay, so you are getting closer to the 0.8, but we will never reach 0.8 if we do not store this infinite number of bits. Is it clear? But obviously computer does not have infinite number of bits. So that's why floating point calculation in any electronic system is not accurate. There will always be a small amount of error incurred in the floating point calculation. But obviously, based upon the precision, there are several tricks and tips that are used that we will discuss throughout when we will do the programming part, that how to avoid this. That means when you will store 13.8, let me show this. Suppose, let me write a small program here.
Sir, can you increase the font size?
Yeah, sure. Let me just. Is it visible? Let me increase it a bit more. Is it visible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, suppose if I write float is the data type that stores real numbers. Suppose I am writing float C, this 13.8. And if I try to print, now it may even round out and will show you exactly 13.8, but internally it will never store 13.8. Let's check it out whether it gives 13.8 or not. Okay, it rounded up and it gave you 13.8 exactly. But suppose if I write something like say 787643, Okay. The fact is internally. Okay, in fact, you will see this, the error that happens in floating point calculation when the equality is checked. I'll show that later on when I'll perform the calculation with equality. Let me just check once. Okay. Because compilers have advanced much. As you can see, that even though it rounded up and showed 13.8 there when I printed it, but when I'm checking for the equality, you'll know about these conditions later on, that it does it what? That it checks whether c is equal to 13.8 or not. Okay, it checks whether c is equal to 13.8 or not. If they are equal, then print yes, otherwise print no. And as you can see, can you see the output? The output has become no. So that means even though I have written c is equal to 13.8 and while printing, due to the internal functionality of printf, it is showing you the rounded value of 13.8. But internally, it is not 13.8 that is stored. Is it clear what I said? It may be some 13.7999 or something like that, but it is not exactly 13.8. It can never be. Is it clear whatever I said?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that's why these are the places where some tricks needs to be used to check the equality. We cannot check two floating point numbers for exact equality. Two floating point numbers, if you store something like this, the constant values, they will never be equal. Okay. So as you can see that during when it gets stored in the computer, we need infinite number of bits to exactly get 0.8, but computer storage is finite. So it will store you some finite number of bits, obviously much larger number that you have tested here. Maybe the eventually after storing it, it will get 0.79999 and so on, and which when showing rounded up, it will be shown as 13.8, but internally it is not 13.8. It is 13.7 something. Now, the question is how many bits are stored eventually? Any of you have any query regarding this real number conversion or real number representation? Any query till now?
Sir, so we can't convert this binary of recurring decimal into normal form, sir?
Yes, you can. But as I have said, if here by using recurring decimal, I am representing that you need infinite number of bits. If some information requires infinite number of bits, obviously you cannot, when you will convert back into decimal, you will never get the exact value. Okay, we will get the value always a bit smaller than the desired value, because to get the exact value, maybe as for example, I'll show you later, just in this class or in my next discussion, that maybe there will be 23 bits will be stored of this, not more. Either 23 bits of this will be stored or 52 bits of this will be stored, depending upon the precision you had used. But obviously, neither 23 nor 52 is infinite. But to get the 0.8 exactly, you'll need infinite number of bits. Okay. Is it clear? So you'll never get 0.8 exactly back.
Okay, sir.
So now I'm going to show you how eventually, internally, how in, is it already 2? Okay, I think no, no, no. I think my clock is showing some
no,
problem.
Sir, 2:30. 2:30.
2:30. No? Just wait for 1 minute. Okay, so what happened here? Okay, so here I'm going to tell you what is going to what will happen in the case of real numbers, how the real numbers are stored within the computer. There is another protocol for that, in fact another standard for that, that is called IEEE 754 floating point standard. Okay, IEEE 754 floating point standard. In this standard, there are several formats for this. First of all, let me tell you that the precision of a number, of a real number, represents is the number of bits used to store the number. And at the same time, which is quite equivalent to the accuracy of the stored number, because the higher the number of bits you will increase to store some particular value, obviously you will get much more closer to the desired information. As for example, in the previous case, as you have seen that with only these first 4 bits 1100 you got 0.75. But as soon as I added 2 further bits, 1, 1, you got 0.796. If you add maybe some more, 5 or 6 more bits, maybe you will get even 0.799 or something like that. And with increasing more and more bits, maybe, as I've said, you will never reach point, never reach 0.8. Maybe 0.799996 it was previously, now it will become 0.79999, right, something like that. So higher the number of bits that you are going to use, the much closer you are going to get to the desired number. That means the higher will be the accuracy. So that's what we define as the precision of a real number. So that will also define, on the other hand, is the accuracy of the stored number. Now, to understand this floating point standard, you have to understand one concept that is called normalization. A normal floating point number, or any normal real number, normal decimal number, has only a single non-zero digit in front of the decimal point. It has only a single non-zero digit in front of the decimal point. That means, suppose if I write something like, say, 3, I am writing in decimal now, 3.9874. It's normal already because there is only a single non-zero digit in front. But if I write something like, say, 105.392, it's not in normalized form. Rather, we can make it normalized by writing 1.05392. And to maintain that, we have to just provide 10 square. Right? Now, this is normal form. This is normal form of the number. Though, depending upon the corresponding usage, depending upon the corresponding standard, this definition of normalization may change a bit, because when performing in the theory of scientific calculations, normalization is generally considered when there is only a single zero in front of the decimal point. So, in such cases, this will be 0.15 and there will be no zero after the decimal point. That means it is just 1 point behind the normalization used in IEEE 754 floating point format. Okay, these two are same. Right?
Sir, is it something like significant figures, sir, that we learn?
Yes, yes, obviously. The number of significant figures is the figures in this normalized form, the number of digits you have after the decimal point. Okay. Not in this one. In this one. Or in general, the total number of digits you are using to represent the corresponding number, including the integer part and the decimal part. That's the number of significant digits.
Sir, we will move all the number till so that all the number which is greater than zero will come to the right side of the decimal.
Your question was not quite clear to me. Tum Hindi mein hi pooch sakte ho.
Sir, hum sare digits ko tab tak move karte rahenge decimal ke right side par, jab tak jitne zero se bade hain wo sab udhar na jaye.
Ha. Jab tak, as for example, if I have, agar mere paas aisa number raha, say 29356.1053. Okay. In this course, but we are not going to use this normal form. Remember, I have shown this just for interest. This is a real normalized form that we use during scientific calculation theory, not calculation. Okay, because these two are readily interchangeable. So, as for example, in this normal form, 0.29356 1053 into 10 to the power 5, right? Okay, this will be the corresponding normal form, but in this theory, but we are not going to use this one. Okay, this is only theoretically interesting. For in reality, within the digital devices, this normal form is used. Is it clear? So in this normal form, this will be 2.93561053 into 10 to the power 4. Is it clear? Is the concept clear till now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, we can do the same thing for binary numbers as well. Suppose I have some number that we have used in the previous page. Let me take this number 1101.11001100 like this. So 1101.11001. Suppose I am going to store only 6 bits after decimal. Okay. So, in this scenario, the number will be, I'm taking this format. Always remember, I'm taking this format. This format is the important one that you are going to discuss in this course. Okay, so in this format, this will become 1.10111. Now I'm going to write this here 0. It's facing some problem again and again. I have to check it out. Okay, so 1.10111. So 1101, it came up to here, then 110011. I wrote this one completely. And to get these two things equal, now our base is 2. Here our base was 10. So we'll multiply 2 cube. 1, 2, 3, right? So this will be our normal form. Is it clear? Any of you have any query regarding the normalization till now? Just the normalization part. Any query till now? Okay. So, next, we are going to see how this normal form is used to represent the real numbers. Here, now, here, in this case, after you have normalized the corresponding, after you have obtained the corresponding normalized form, based upon the precision, there are two different precisions. First one is the 32-bit precision. In the 32-bit precision, the complete number is represented using 32-bit number, which is also called single precision. Okay. In the single precision, the real number is represented in 32 bits. Okay. And among these 32 bits, it has multiple fields. This 32 bit is divided into three separate fields. The first bit is only a single bit, is called the sign bit. Next 8 bits is the exponent bit. And the last 23 bits is the mantissa bit. Now I'll explain each of this field. This sign field S, it is a single bit. It is 0 for positive, 1 for negative. Okay. This exponent field, it is the exponent of the number. Which one is the exponent here? As for example, this is called the exponent. Here 3 is the exponent. Okay, let me write this number on that page again. 1.10. Okay, let me write this one first. 1101, 1100, and so on. So 1101.1100, 1100. Suppose I am using only 6 bits, I'll remove these two ones, two zeros. Now here, this is normal. In normalized form, this will be 1.10111001 into 2 cube. Now this 3, this is the exponent, whereas this part is the mantissa, not including 1, excluding 1, this part is the mantissa. Now in this exponent field, you will have to write exponent added with a bias. And the bias value for this case is 127. That means you will simply not write 3 here, rather you will add 127 to it, and then you will write its binary conversion into that exponent field. Remember, while writing the exponent, you do not need to think about 2's complement. That field is completely positive. Haan, bolo.
What is this 127?
Okay, it's a bias that has been chosen for this single precision number. I'll demonstrate this. As for example, in this case, the exponent field will be 3 plus 127, that means 130. Now what will be the binary conversion of 130? Now you may ask why this 127 needs to be added. I'll show that with an example. You'll understand why it has been chosen to be added. So 1000010. So for this number, I'm taking that number 13.8, right? That was 13.8 in decimal, which I converted into 1.101110011 into 2 cube. Now, as the number is a positive number, the sign bit will be 0, right? The exponent here is 3. So in the exponent field, we'll have to write the 130, its corresponding binary. 130 is in decimal. If you convert it into binary, 8-bit binary, because exponent is of 8-bit, the value that you will get, you have to write it there. 1000010. That will be an exponent field. And in the mantissa field, 23-bit mantissa field, this mantissa will come purely. This one will not be included. Only in the normalized part, only the decimal part will be the mantissa. So this part only, this will come as the mantissa part. So 1011100. And here to fill up the complete 23 bits. This will be of 23 bits. So obviously 0 will not be filled up there. Rather 11001100110011100 and so on.
Sir.
Okay.
Haan,
bolo.
What if, they say wahan pe 0.25 tha na?
Haan, 0.25.
सॉरी 0.25 था. अब 0.25 के लिए तो सर वो नंबर आ गया था शायद 11 समथिंग कुछ आ गया था जो भी
हां 10.10 इट विल बी फिल्ड अप विद कंप्लीट जीरो देन.
ओके या सर मैं यही पूछ रहा था. थैंक यू.
ओके सो सर आई विल शो ऑल पॉसिबल एग्जांपल्स. सपोज
सर
दैट 4.25. ओके सर 4.25 वाज. हां बोलो
सर. व्हाट इज दैट नंबर सर बिफोर दैट 23 बिट्स.
01000. 01000. Okay. this one.
No, sir. 01000010.
01000.
Sir, exponential and sign number. I think he's asking about.
01. There is it. Okay. This one.
So
this
zero
one. Sorry.
Is sign number and then exponential number.
This zero is the sign. This zero is a sign bit. There is one sign bit in the front. Okay, that sign bit represent that si- for in that sign bit zero. That is a single bit a sign bit. If it is zero, that means the number is positive. If it is one, that means the number is negative. As I am representing on the 13.8, it is positive. So I have written the zero here. Okay, then. The next bit, then the next 8 bits are the exponent bit. They are the exponent field. Now, the exponent field, to represent the exponent field, you have to add a bias. Bias of 127. Why do you need to do that? I'll show you. Okay. But the main focus is that the exponent field needs to be positive because there is no concept of 2's complement or the negative number in the exponent. Okay, so the exponent should be positive. That's why 127 is added. So if you add 127 to 3, you'll get 130. And 130's binary conversion is 1000. Check it out here. 1000, then 0010. 0010. So this is the exponent. This is the exponent part.
Sir,
huh?
In this case, in exponent field, if the number comes out to be 7 bit, so we will add a 0 at leftmost.
Yes. You'll have to add a 0 at the leftmost bit.
Okay.
Does it answer your question about what
yes,
these
sir.
Bits?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So this is the mantis part, huh?
Sir, in the mantissa part, the thing that you've written, what have you basically extended to make it 23 bits?
Okay. In fact, 13.8 here, if you can remember, it was infinite number of bits, right? So it was 1100, 1100, 1100, and so on. So here, if you write this 13.8, this is it. This is in fact 1101.1100.1100. This is an infinite number of bits continuously. Here, first 1011. That means I am going to normalize it. 1011. Then 1001100.1100, and so on into 2 cube. This is the part truncated at 23rd bit. That's what I've written here. 101.
Okay,
okay.
Understood.
Any other query? Okay. In fact, it will be more clear as we'll go through more examples. Suppose this 4.25 here. Okay. 4.25, as you have seen, 100 point, it was only 01. If you can remember that, we have represented it here. 100.01. Right? So in that case, obviously, it does not fit infinite number of bits. You have to normalize it. 1.0001 into 2 square. Okay. So, as this is a positive number, again, there will be a 0 here. Then, the exponent field, in the exponent field, the exponent is to add 127 to it, you will get 129. So, the binary format, the binary conversion of 129 needs to be added. In fact, this will be, this is 130 is this, 130 was this, you have to just get a number adding 1 to which you will get this one. So 1 0 0 0 0 0 0 1. If you get 1 2, this will be 0 and you will, this will be 1. First few bits are wrong. So this is the binary conversion of 129. You can check it out. Okay. So this will be the exponent field. And in the Mantissa field is now finite. So 0, 0, 0, 1, then 0, 0, 23. Is the concept clear to all of you? In fact, at the 5 to 6 class, a few more, a bit more complex examples, and then we'll go to the double position. Okay. So, I'll keep my discussion up to you.
Sir,
now, haan, bolo.
Sir, the maximum power here we can see that we have 2 square 2 cube, no, sir. So, the maximum power can be only 129, no, sir. 128, no, sir.
Yes, because using 8 bits, the maximum number that you can represent is this.
25.
This is 255. Right, so obviously subtract 127 to it, that's 128. This is the maximum power, 2 to the power, that means some number into 2 to the power 128 is the maximum number that you can represent in single position. Okay, and the minimum number, that means some number into 2 to the power 128 is the maximum number that you can represent. And some number into 2 to the power minus 127 is the minimum number that you can represent. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
In fact, for this part, 127
sir,
is
added. Sir, why? We subtracted 127 from 255.
Your question was not clear.
Sir, why we subtracted 127 from 255, sir?
Okay. Why did I subtract 127 from 255? The question was that what is the maximum number that you can represent in this single precision number, single precision format? Your exponent is of only 8 bits. So, this is the maximum number that you can store in your exponent field with 8 ones. Obviously, you cannot go above that. Right? This is unsigned. All bits are value bits. And this number represents 255. Okay. So, obviously, if some number's exponent is 128, then you have to add 127 to it and you'll get 255 to put it here. Though, let me tell you, the study of IEEE 754 standard is much deeper. This all ones is not used in number representation. So, in reality, in practical scenarios, you will get only up to 2 to the power 127 with all ones stored to store some special values that I will show you later. That is called NA, not a number. That means when you divide some number by 0, that's impossible mathematically. The result that comes, that is not a number, but it has a special symbol that is called NaN, and that is represented by all ones in the exponent field. But don't go into that complexity now. It will be clear step by step. Okay. Okay. Is it clear? Whatever I said, just forget about the NaN now. If you have not understood, I'll demonstrate the concept of NaN in very details later on, and how that is implemented within the number system. But just know that it is, in reality, it is 127 up to which you can represent.
Okay.
Sir, that that will come when our program has any error or anything or any other reason.
If you suppose you have, if you divide by zero, your program will not give you any error. Your program will simply show you an exception. That is called floating point exception. Let me demonstrate this. Suppose if I write you, okay, you have class from 3, right? I'll show you this from I'll show you this at 5 to 6. Okay. Okay. So I'm keeping my discussion up to this. We'll see you at 5 to 6.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Well, thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.